Let's get back to the ultra lazy thing. So let's see. I don't think there was anything needing immediate attention. Maybe a couple of these walls, actually. Yeah, some of these walls could use some patching up, I suppose. Let's start with doing that. Hello, Tiny. Welcome and Happy New Year to you, too. But yeah, so last time we had a few issues with everything being on fire because the biters were trying to eat everything all the time. But it seems like we've been able to stabilize now that we have flamethrowers pretty much everywhere. And we got some oil processing started making some plastic. And next up is going to be to start making blue signs and researching robots. And that is going to be a very important milestone. Right, that is good. And anything else? Yeah, let's go up there as well. So this will take me there. So for blue signs, I need a couple of things. So I'm going to build 24 of these, which means I need 3 advanced circuits per cycle. Which means I only really need half of this to power that with circuits. I might want a dedicated red circuit factory for the blue signs though. What else do I need? One sulfur. I think I only need one sulfur assembler for that, if I remember correctly. Yeah, so one per cycle, and this makes, yeah, 2 per cycle, so yeah, I only need one for those. And then 2 engine units per cycle, which means I need 24 of those because I have, yeah, 5 and 12 of those, yeah, right. So I need 2 engine units per cycle, which means I need 20 engine unit assemblers. Yeah, which means I will just do 1-to-1 insertion of those, actually. There's not really much point in saving 4 assemblers of engine units. Okay, so this will take me back down. All the way to there. I think I want to go there though. Or maybe to the train. Yeah, I'll probably go to the train instead. So that I can take the train over to here, fix that. And yeah, let's fix that one as well while we're at it. So I'm going to need 24 blue size assemblers, 24 engine unit assemblers, which means I also need some gears and pipes, right? So, effectively, I only need 20, which means I need 2 gear wheels per cycle and 4 pipes per cycle, so it's only one of each of those, yeah. No, 2 pipe assemblers and 1 gear wheel assembler. Okay. go there first. So we're just wall segments, right? Yeah. Oh, that's gonna need fixing as well. Oh, hello. Ah. You should not be doing that. You should wait here. Get me out of here. Okay. Wow. So what about this one? You're going here, okay. Likewise, this train should wait inside the walls as well. Where are you going? You're going there. Oh. There we go, okay. That was a bit scary there. Fortunately, locomotives turns out have a lot of health. No. Ah, why do I keep doing that? There, now I can turn it and get out. Okay. Maybe fix that and that as well while I'm here. We'll make this a red. Did I leave? Yeah, I did leave the locomotive. So this belt will take me there. Now let's see where we build the sites. Actually, let's just lay it out first so I know approximately how big it'll be. How many is that? That is 15, so I need 9 more. So like that, yeah, 24. And then 1, 2. And then I need 2 gears and pipes somewhere in here. Probably like that. Oh, I'm out of those, okay. So, let's go back there. And let's see. Let's grab one of those. And one of those. It's probably better to flip this around, isn't it? So I can have this closer to there. And then I just need steel here as well. And yeah, I need one in there. I need a belt in there as well for circuits and sulfur. And output. That should be all. actually... going to redo these. Because these are a bit ugly, I want... or rather, this is a bit ugly, I want it like this instead. Stack inserts finished. Nice. Let's get started on explosives, so we can make cliff explosives soon enough. And that means I can now set up those. I should have built those already, but I guess I hadn't. Oh, and I don't have any of those. Okay. So that's going to be stack and stack filter. These are limited. Good. Let's make 100 of each. Like I have a bit of an issue with well, throughput here. Oh yeah, because these are only lifting one per cycle, aren't they? Yeah, just one per cycle, okay. How many stack size 1 plus 1, okay. Alright. I'm gonna need to upgrade those. Do I want to do that right away? Maybe. No, not yet. Right, science. So this input might actually need to be like that, so I can have this input there instead. For iron plates. And then, do I want a dedicated red circuit here? Maybe I do. Or do I just want to take this one? I'm gonna need more than this anyway, so I'll just duplicate this. And put one here as well. And let's see. Can we flip that? Oh wait, it is facing the right direction already. Might need it like that, though. So what if I do that? How big is that? I can definitely not fit that in here. Could squeeze it in down here, maybe? I guess I can also move the circuit thing slightly. So if I take just this one... I could squeeze that in here, maybe? Where else? Maybe somewhere around here? Can I... I guess I could actually make this like double-sided? Yeah, maybe that's a bit better. If I take half of that... Let's see, where... do I have some... I have some space there, maybe? No. I want somewhere I can build this without having to worry about the cliffs. Down here, maybe? Let's just do it here. No? Not quite. Maybe here? Here works. So then I can do that. Maybe that works a bit better, or is at least easier to squeeze in here. Okay, I could squeeze that in here. And I think I will. Maybe flip it so that I can have the iron and copper coming in from the top. See, I don't... Do I need more labs on this? If I do, I guess I can expand that later. So let's get rid of this. Probably get rid of this as well and move it somewhere else. So let's put that here, I suppose. This pipe will have to move, but that's okay. Oh wait, that science belt is in the way, slightly in the way. So let's go down there then. Yeah, that looks okay. Right. Anything else I need to do? Perhaps bring this with me. So let's see, how many assemblers was that? 46. That's more than I have, so I'm gonna need more. Take all of those. I can use a few of these. Because these don't really need to be level 2 ones. Oh, it's just low on gears. Should bring some more power poles as well. Just take all of those. Oh, whoops. We are really low on power. And why is that? Oh, because a power coal belt somewhere is broken? Yeah, a coal belt somewhere is broken. Looks like there, okay. Looks like we're going to have a blackout very soon. Hello, the ducks. As Factorio player, I want you to inform you that we have 2022 already. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Okay, Okay, so this is fine, yeah, so it's up here. Yeah, there it is. Let's see if I can reach that. Not quite. Can I reach it from here, though? Okay, okay. Oh, he means 1 hour in Factorio is 8 weeks in real life, yeah. I guess so. So now I just need to wait for the coal to get here. And meanwhile I cannot do this because I can't see it. It's annoying that I don't have a vision of the coal belt. There it is. I guess this is a reason to use these burner inserters here. Maybe I should put just one or two of those. Don't have any ingredients, so I won't. See if this can get back on its feet. No. Oh, these are struggling to pick up anything. There we go. Now let's see if this can rise. Okay, looks like we're doing fine now. So now, science. This a while ago. So this will have to move to about there. Maybe a bit further down actually. These damn power poles. And their wires. Oh no, these aren't aligned anymore. Okay, let's get cliff explosives. So that we can start properly terraforming this place if we need to. I guess terraforming is a bit of an exaggeration, but yeah, you know what I mean. Okay. So then we also need some red circuits in here and some, of course, iron. And finally, sulfur. Also need some recipes. Wrong one. So we need iron here. Where do we get to that then? Guess there's a bit of a mess of iron up here. So I'm gonna have some iron here. Oh, I guess I could just take this belt, I suppose. So this one goes into the mall and into the circuits. Yeah, so that's the mall. Yeah, I'll just take this, I think. Question is how, though? Down there, no, that doesn't work. Could also move these. Oops. No. Move these around a bit. Something like that. And that. I don't think that really helps, actually. But I can also do like this. And then I can do that. And there we go. And there's a small belt of iron. Okay. So then we need, what else? Steel. There. the steel will have to come in a similar way somehow. So we can take, I would like to split it here somehow. Can do like that. And then doesn't quite work. So I have this. And, I don't think I want to put the steel on the same belt as the iron, because actually I need, how many? 2 engine units per cycle, which means, yeah, I need 16 iron plates actually per cycle, which is more than one yellow belt. Could do it with a red belt, I suppose, which means I would get 15 per cycle on one half of that, or per second, I guess, which is, yeah, right, because belts are in seconds and not in cycles, so half a red belt of iron would actually be enough. Maybe that's fine. So then we would have this there. Although I don't have red undergrounds right now though. So what if I do this then? Get a bit more space there. What if I move this up here? No. Still doesn't work. That, though. That means I could do this. That just leaves to figure out how to do with this one. No. Hmm. Oh. Can probably do just like this. And then... yeah, that works. So then this will be the iron instead. And like that, and the steel goes. Right, so the engines are producing. Good. So then I just need the red circuits and the sulfur. I also need to hook this up to the lamps, which are up there, which means I maybe should reroute this belt to come from the other side. Coming from here instead. Good. Let's leave a bit of space here. So for now I'll just take this one, put it in there, the red circuits I mean, and I will just do it like this. Actually no, I will, oh yeah, actually yes, and just move this one a bit. So we can take that in here. Sulfur here. Which needs just water and petroleum. I think I dropped all my offshore pumps. Yeah, I did. Don't aggro me, please. Okay. We're good. And then I just need to connect the petroleum gas over here. So that goes from here. And let's bring that in south of this. Straight through these turrets. That should get this running. This is working, that is working. And yeah, there's blue signs. I think this should be enough to satisfy all of these. Let's wait for a moment to see that that is actually the case. These are working, that is working, and this is working. Perfect! Finally, let's go clean up that iron trash chest. Now this is very close to getting robots and getting to the point where I don't really need to move anymore. And getting to that point is going to be very, very nice. So let's set up the rest of these as well. Okay, so now let's move on towards robots. Alright, I also need these. Fast oil processing is coming along nicely. And let's think about where to put a robot factory. Or actually, I think I'm gonna take a break here actually. Make it a short session this time. But I'll probably be back later today. You did hear robots this talks. It's gonna be, I don't know, probably another hour or two or something like that, but it's definitely going to be very soon. I would say it's definitely going to be in the next session. But yeah, I'm going to take a bit of a break. I'll be back later today, I believe. And yeah. Thanks everyone who's been watching. Until then, have a good time, and we'll see you in the next session.